Measles itself can, in 1 in 100 cases, cause a pneumonia, which is the leading cause of death for people who have measles. In 1 in 1,000, it can cause a swelling in the brain. These are very serious conditions, and we were able to achieve the eradication of measles in this country through the process of mandatory vaccination of school-age children. Unvaccinated children create not only a risk to the individual children, but a risk to your neighbor's children as well. And particularly when you think about those individuals among us who have particular susceptibilities. They might be suffering from HIV, they might be suffering from important allergies that don't allow them to get the vaccine. We have been seeing an alarming increased numbers of measles cases, which are the result of this very broad religious exemption. A religious exemption which is not consistent with a legislative intent. What the bill says is that in order to utilize a religious exemption to keep your child from being immunized against vaccine-preventable diseases, you must, in writing, state a bona fide religious reason why your child should not receive a vaccination. No one is arguing that that should not exist. We have to work around these things. But right now, that religious exemption has been used really by people who don't share a strong religious view about it, but who just reject the idea of vaccines because, in spite of all the evidence, they believe vaccines are dangerous. And in spite of all of the examples in our society where we work together to achieve an end, they have decided they're going to go it alone and really not respect, I think, this great idea that we are in it together and that we do have responsibility not only for ourselves, but for our neighbors as well.